With the release of Season 4, it gives us a whole new reason to play the MCC. So in this video, I'm going to go over how to earn your Season Points and XP the most efficient way possible while playing the game. So stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another tips and tricks video when it comes to the MCC. If you like these kind of videos, make sure you tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this, and it greatly helps out the video and channel. So let's get right into it. With the recent release of Season 4 on MCC, it brings obviously Halo 4 and a whole suite of new seasonal challenges to play for us guys. So in this video, I'm going to tell you exactly how to go about playing your game time the most efficient way possible to earn your seasonal points to get through the new season pass for Season 4, and how to rank up to flex your awesome skills within the MCC. So the main thing you want to focus on when you're trying to rank up and earn your season points is to focus on the challenge system within the MCC. Right here you can see that we have weekly PvP, weekly PvE, seasonal, and we also have a special recon one that's only lasting for the last week of this new season. Weekly PvP stuff resets every Wednesday at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. There's always 5 seasonal points for you to earn every new week, which is very awesome, with additional challenges on top of that as well, highlighted in blue. The seasonal point ones highlighted in a goldish yellow kind of color. Same thing with PvE as well, as you can see over here. Similar kind of situation as well, with a ton of extra challenges with 5 seasonal points to be added on top of that as well. So the main thing you want to look into is trying to how to synergize your time spending out on how to grind out these seasonal points and XP while merging that with your weekly challenges on top of that. Now I want to go into some math I want to show you guys real quick. I know it's math, this is gonna hurt my brain, but trust me, this is important information for you guys to know as well. So for PvP challenges, you can see you have 5 seasonal points, PvE 5 seasonal points as well per week. The PvP challenges earning you about 235,000 XP, while PvE stuff earns you 375,000 XP. Now you're probably thinking, oh god, that's a huge XP disparity between the two. Like, why would I just be playing PvE the whole time? Well, you also got to take in consideration that the games that you're playing on the MCC for multiplayer grant you XP on top of that. And pretty much every game within the MCC gives you a decent amount of XP besides Halo 3. Halo 3 is actually rather abysmal when it comes to earning XP points, so I highly suggest playing anything else besides Halo 3. Beyond that, you're just kind of splitting hairs on exactly what game mode and what game you want to play and stuff like that. Generally, guys, just don't play Halo 3 if you're looking to earn XP points and grind up to that coveted blue shield I'm sure a lot of you guys are looking for. So you can see the seasonal points right here, quite a lot of difference right here. We have only 3 seasonal points for PvP challenges, 27 seasonal point challenges for PvE, and you can see the XP disparity between the two as well, where PvP only gets you 125,000, while PvE earns you 480,000 XP. And then we do have the current event of the Recon Slayer earn, get up to rank 20, and you earn a new weapon skin, which is cool, but it doesn't earn any season points, but it does give you 50k XP. So let's look at the seasonal challenges and how we can pair them with the weekly challenges and how we can optimize our game time together, guys. So right now for the top two ones, we have 2 weapon skins you can earn within Halo 4's squad battle mode, which is a ranked playlist. So then you'll have to, you know, earn rank 15 to get the blood splatter skin, which looks awesome, and earn rank 25 to earn the blast skin as well. This can be paired in with like the, you know, assisting teammates. You get 25 assists within a game, you can earn some season points. Here's another challenge for you guys: complete match made games with an average life of 35 seconds or longer. You can do that literally in anything right there. Web quality, win competitive match made games. Obviously, you just gotta win 2 of those. That gets you a season point. So even though you're not getting any season points for winning or going towards this seasonal challenge, you can still get them within doing the challenges. And on top of that, once you do this challenge, you get 20k XP. These two earn 50k XP and 75k XP on top of that. And this one, there is a spree medal within the weekly PvP stuff. Obviously, that might be a little bit easier to do in social, because in ranked, it gets a little bit harder to kind of go on different sprees. And the rest are various XP ranked ones. And these are just kind of just general things to do, like, you know, get kills with starting weapons, you know, do certain medals, or all kind of various things, like do some vehicle stuff. And so it doesn't really affect you too much when it comes to seasonal points there. So it's not going to help you too much on your seasonal grind when it comes to unlocking everything, which you're going to need 50 season points this season to unlock everything in season 4. Again, like I said, with these two weapon skins, you can look at this other one, the Boost Sequence Challenge, which is just complete match-made multiplayer games in Halo 4. So even though you're not earning any seasonal points with this, you're still getting on the road to hopefully earn your XP and weapon skins, but you're also working on your way for your 3 seasonal points on your multiplayer match-made games, which are only for Halo 4. So you have to play Halo 4. So you're kind of doubling up on that. And this one also kind of stacks either way, whichever one you look at it. This is like match-made games just in general, because it's either multiplayer or firefight. You earn 3 seasonal XP points with 35k XP thrown on top of that. And that's just the MCC just in general, just to play 50 match-made games, which is pretty nice. And now this is where you kind of start seeing some different PvP stuff you can probably synergize together. Night Night, Sleep Tight is where you defeat enemies with Forerunner weapons in any game mode on normal difficulty or harder. Now that one you can actually team up with like the Shorty one, where it's just complete campaign missions on normal difficulty or higher. That gets you some more XP and additional season point for the weekly PvE challenges. Defeat core infantry member enemies in PvE modes that would mainly be Spartan Ups, but firefight, campaign, things like that. And also the 20 grand challenge of earning in-game score of at least 20,000 points. But we can also kind of team that up with something else around here, which is a complete Halo 4 campaign playlist, which guarantees you 3 XP. So if you hop over to the campaign side of things, you can actually kind of look over. Canyon Combat one is a good one. You get a lot of Forerunners within that one, especially on the mission Forerunner itself. And also Tight Corridors will help you out a little bit there as well. Especially with the last two missions being shut down at midnight, you find a lot of Forerunners there. You get a lot of Forerunner weapons to take on, guys. So here's another one where you can earn 6 seasonal points and 100k XP if you combine these two together. So it's a complete Spartan 4 Ops chapters. If you complete 10 chapters, you get 3 seasonal points and 50k XP. And if you complete 20, 3 seasonal points, top that off with XP points. Now you can also look over here to the PvE side of things. Again, if you look over, like say, like the weekly warriors, defeat core infantry enemies in PvE modes, that's an extra seasonal point right there with 25k experience. You can probably knock that out within a single play session because it's only 100. Not that much when it comes to core enemies. Just kind of, you know, you want to take some time, read through these challenges and kind of understand exactly how to coordinate your game time properly to optimize your game time so you can get your seasonal points, get your XP as efficiently as possible. As you can see right now, I'm sitting at 53 season points. I can lock everything right now within season 4 within the first week of the game being out. That's because I've saved up previously, but you can kind of see where I'm getting at. So hopefully after watching this video, you get an idea of exactly what we're talking about. So you want to take some time, see what's available for you to play, what you want to play, and how you can kind of coordinate everything together to really rack up that XP and seasonal points within the challenge system. The way I would go about doing it right now, if you're really trying to get like those new weapon skins that are tied to ranked Halo 4, I highly suggest you actually prioritize that first, because it seems like within the MCC, either the ranked playlist, get a nice spike of population as soon as the game goes live, and then we'll kind of dwindle off over time just because people get less interested in it and things like that. We do see that there's a higher spike in population people playing now that there's incentives tied to these different ranks within ranked modes, but definitely want to focus on that if you're trying to get those weapon skins. Other than that though, you can just kind of play around how you like, especially because most of the seasonal challenges are tied to PvE content, which is, you know, you can play whenever, really. There's no matchmaking algorithm really to it. There's no input-based matchmaking or anything for like firefight games, which is a great way to knock out a lot of the seasonal content, guys. You can get your match-made games in, you can get your core enemy types taken out, you can get your specific weapon types taken out as well. And I also probably would suggest playing through some of the campaign playlists as well, especially for Halo 4, since there are 3 playlists that are only 3 missions long. And also, I would just highly suggest just playing through the Halo 4 campaign on at least like normal or heroic difficulty, because I've been doing it and it's actually kind of fun. Let me know in the comment section down below, guys, if this video helped you out. I'll make sure to do more of these kind of tips and trick videos for you guys while season 4 is still hot off the press for the MCC. So thank you so much for watching and I greatly appreciate it. If you've been out of the loop for the last few days or so, check out the videos on the screen right now. I got a link to all my news and informational videos if you missed anything recently. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.